Sometimes. Sometimes we have to let people go from how they've spoken to us more than anything. And called us some ungodly and some awful names, like a marble in a washing machine, a pebble in a shoe. Sometimes. Yeah, I forgive you, but all the things you said and called me, how can we pick up and go on? Sticks and stones will break my bones, and I prefer that you hit me with a baseball bat than to stab me with the things you said to me. This is truth and not facts, because facts change. You destroyed us with your words, not just your lies. But the things that you called me in this day and age, the things that you texted me, the awful things that you said, I'm not holding against you, but I forgive you. I can move everything out of the way, even the words, the painful things you have said to me, but yet, the marble in the washing machine, the things you have said, the awful name calling and accusations, insinuations, insults, and assaults have piled up. And I have discovered in 52 years of living that the more you take verbal abuse, the more it conditions you to take more, and then you know your self-esteem is gone. He used to call you this, he used to call you blank, then he called you blank and blank and blank, 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 or she used to call you blank, blank, now she's calling you blankety blank, 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 blank. Yes, why? Continue to subject your heart and mind and your spirit to these injurious words, this marble in the washing machine. I hear it going around and around. You got me going in circles, day in, day out. Oops, you said it again, but this time you added emphasis in quotes. You said you never said it again, but in this day and age, people will text you their insult, having to form it in their frontal lobe to think about it, proofread it, and to send. I've never seen anybody really abbreviate cuss words. They spell them out. People will say K-N-O without the W. One letter, why? But the verbal abuse. Sticks and stones have broken my bones. I prefer to hit me with a baseball bat, a baton, a stick, than gouge big old bloody holes in my heart, mind, from your words. And the same letters and words, W-O-R-D-S, is the same letters and sword, S-W-O-R-D. Why? How can we continue? The marble in the washing machine. I forgive you. You know there is four choices with forgiveness. I can choose to forgive and stay, forgive and go, not forgive and stay, or not forgive and go. But how can we continue? I have a dictionary of words that you have placed upon my heart and mind, my psyche, my mental, my emotional, my environmental, yes, your verbal, the things you've said to me, man. How can we pick up where we left off there? It just will be more verbal abuse. Such injurious things, and I'm not exempt, and I'm not perfect, but I've discovered that the more I took, you got progressively and progressively worse. Why? I kept saying, please stop, don't say that, as you text away. It's the truth. In this day and age, people will text you their insults, their insinuations, their assaults, their assumptions, proofread, and send. They don't, I never see anybody abbreviate or misspell cuss words. D. Why would you continue to injure me over and over and over again and again? Sticks and stones, baseball bat, a 2x4, an aluminum bat, a weight, a stone, a rock. I'll take it all. But the things you have said, a lot of us have violated this law and have killed a person without words, and we wonder why we can't hold a hand. We can't kiss them. We'll prayerfully possibly never see them again. Sticks and stones have broken my bones. God bless you. Peace. Why?